One day, a therapist, psychiatrist from the University of California in Berkeley asked me in front of a group of young intellectuals to define evil. What is evil? And you could tell by the sarcasm on the edge of his voice, he didn't believe in evil, which in itself was evil. And so I thought to myself, what is evil? And I found in the Word of God one of the best examples of evil, and then I'm going to explain very quickly why you need to know and you need to own a proper definition of evil. The Bible tells us that a man who couldn't walk, every day Peter saw him when he went to pray, approximately 9 o'clock in the morning. He was the best known handicapped person in all of Jerusalem. Everybody knew him. Sometime God will do a miracle and he'll wait until it reaches its most explosive and dynamic potential. Then he'll heal him. And every day Peter walked by that man. That man knew Peter. Peter knew that man. That's why even before anything else, the man lifted up his cup expecting something from the man of God who prayed every day. But Peter, watch me, knew that man was supposed to be healed. You know, right now in front of me, even before I begin to pray for the sick, I will know of things in the audience. I'll know about cancer. I'll know about a brutal car accident that almost killed you. And I'll know. And sometime when you're young, young preachers are immature, they speak their mind immediately. They don't allow the Spirit of God to coalesce the word that they have received, because they're afraid it might go away. But the Holy Spirit is so loving that he won't do that. He'll even feel honored by the fact that you wait until you know that you know that you know that you're carrying a word from God. Now, the man at the gate, beautiful, had no idea of how his life was about to be changed. Everything, how he lived, how he believed, how he acted, every last drop of his life was about to change forever. Do you know that's you? And that's you. And that's you. You think you're always going to be afraid, always going to be depressed, always going to put that needle in your arm or snort that powder. You're always going to be hurting. You're always going to be in a relationship that's disastrous. But that is going to change by the power of God tonight. How many of you did Christ change your life? How many of you can declare openly right now, Jesus changed my life completely? Go ahead and shout right now. If Christ has changed your life. Jesus told Peter that one day he would be martyred. Jesus didn't get in trouble until he started healing the sick. As long as he just spoke, he was okay. But when what he said was accompanied by miracles, suddenly he's the enemy of the state. And they want him dead. Peter was watching. That's why I believe that he walked by that man, because every day he's trying to think, I know he's supposed to get up and walk. Look at me right now. That tumor that's in your body, I believe tonight is your night for that to go away and for you to be healed of cancer in Jesus' name. Now, but Peter didn't want to do it, I believe. He was afraid. One day, God tricked him to leave his money on the dresser. So as he automatically reached for it, it wasn't there. And now he has that cringe moment. you know I'm good for it. I've given you money every day. But today, I don't have it. Then he started getting upset, like, I want some of you. I want you to get angry with your life. Aren't you sick and tired of the daily grind of fear and doubt? And Peter felt that threat that one day he might be martyred, or he would be. And he said, you know, I don't have the money. And you know what? I'm not supposed to have the money. Can I say something to all the preachers in this room? How many of you let me go aside for a minute, talk to the preachers that are in this room? You know that you want a signs and wonders ministry. You know you do. You're sick and tired of relying on Greek verbs. You want the anointing. You want the power of God. How many of you believe that church is where the wheelchairs ought to be emptied, the blind eyes open, and the miracles of God happening? How many of you believe that? Well, all of a sudden, Peter said, I don't have the money. You know what? I'm not supposed to have the money. You know what? I've been renting. When I'm giving you money, I'm paying rent for days of powerless ministry. I'm trying to extend my period of not having power. You know, sir, God doesn't want you to preach that stuff you've been preaching. The people can't tell when it's you or when it's a Chinese fortune cookie. You want to preach the word. You want to sound like a lion, not a therapist. You want to get up and quit trying to do stand-up. Do this. Tell the devil he's done with your church. Tell the devil he can't have your... I'm going to say something right here. You tell the devil right now, my worship service is going to be powerful and free. And if there's a board member that doesn't like it, he can go to another church and take his tithe with him. Because whatever money he leaves with, God will replenish it through somebody else. How many of you believe we ought to go ahead and just have church? Yes. I don't have the money. Not supposed to have the money. I'm sorry I had the money. Silver and gold have I none, but what I have, listen to me. What do we have to say to the universities and the colleges and the hospitals and the doctors and the social media of today? What do we have to say to them? That Christianity is a self-help program that we fit in neatly alongside of Islam and Buddhism? No, we don't. He is the way, the truth, and the life. No man, come on, help me, comes unto the Father but by him. In the name of Jesus, get up and walk. Ladies and gentlemen, he got up. He got up. And he started leaping and praising God. The arms work. The legs work. I don't have to beg anymore. I'm not trapped in this spot. I don't have to be carried anymore. And he got up and ran into the temple, and everyone that was praying to God saw the paralyzed man, and he's walking, and great joy broke out. I wonder if there's any joy in this place right now. Is there any joy in this place?